Hi there, in this video I'll show you ways that you can help protect your website images. I should start out by saying that this is not a foolproof guide. As long as your website is online, people can get access to it and download it, but you can take steps to make it difficult for them to do this, and I'll go ahead and show you some things that you can do. The first thing that you can do is make sure that you have a copyright notice at the bottom of each page. Right now I have a demo document opened in WebEasySite, and if I scroll down at the bottom, you'll see I have a copyright text here with the date that the content was created plus a name. By adding this text, it lets people know that this content is copyrighted, and if it wasn't there, people would consider this public use, which means they can download it. So all you need to do is just create a text box and type in that information. Sometimes getting that little copyright symbol to show up can be tricky in WebEasy. So what I usually do is go into my accessories and open up my notepad. And then I'll just type in that information there, and then where I want the copyright symbol, I'll hold down my Alt key on my keyboard, and then on my number pad, type in 0169, and that copyright symbol will show up. And then you can just copy and paste this into the text box in WebEasy. The next thing that you can do is to consider watermarking your images. And I'll give you an example so you can see what I'm talking about. In this image that I've saved on my computer, I've watermarked some copyright text in the lower left-hand corner. And it's basically text or an image that's superimposed upon your main image, and it lets people know who the author is or where it was found at on the web. To watermark your image, you can do this in a common image editing program like Photoshop, but if you don't have one installed, you can do this on the web for free. So all you need to do is to open up a web browser, and then in the address bar go to www.picmarkr.com, and that's PICMARKR.com, and it's a neat website. It allows you to upload 5 photos at once, and then you can either watermark a text or an image in any part of the photo. Then what you do is you would save that photo and embed it back into your WebEasy program. And in my opinion, this is the best option to do if you're concerned about protecting your website images. The remaining options that I'll be going through can be circumvented if you know how to do that. The third thing that you can do to help protect your images is to disable right clicks. Oftentimes when people want to download an image, they would right click on a photo and select Save Picture As. So you can actually disable this function in WebEasy. So to do this, you'll need to go up to the Insert tab at the very top, and then go down to Object. And this will open up an Insert Object window. So you need to make sure you click on the Objects tab. And then you'll need to scroll down in the list, and then you're going to see an option here for No Right Click. So you'll need to select that and then press OK. Then you can click anywhere on the page you want to add this object. And this will open up an object properties and ask you to add a text note. So what you need to do is you need to double click the value to edit this. And this is the notice that people will get when they'll try to right click. So what I usually put in is like right clicks are disabled. And then you can go ahead and press OK. And then you'll see the icon here for it. That just lets you know that right clicks are disabled on the page. Your visitors won't see this when they're actually on the page. So what you can do is you can actually copy and paste this object into any other pages you would like to have the right clicks disabled on. The fourth thing that you can do is to disable browser caching for your website. So whenever you go to a page on the web, your browser will download all the images for that page to a folder on your computer. This allows the browser to bring up the page quicker, but people can go into this folder and obtain your images. So to disable this feature, we'll need to add a script into WebEasy. So what you'll need to do first is to turn on the Inspector window. So you'll need to go up at the very top to the View menu and then select Inspector or press Control K. And this will open up a column on the right, and in the upper right hand corner, you'll need to press the Properties page icon and select Document. And it's the very bottom, and it's kind of cutting off there on the screen. Then make sure you're under the Properties tab, and then you'll need to expand the Page Settings row that's in blue. Just click the little plus icon next to it, and that will drop down, and at the very bottom you'll see a section here for Head Elements. You'll need to double click the value on the right, And this will open up a text edit window. So what you'll need to do is you'll need to paste in this new cache script. So I'll go ahead and right click and then select paste. And then it'll have the code at the bottom here. So what you can do is you can pause the video and then write down this code so that way you can enter it into your program. So all you need to do is just hit OK and then that will take care of the caching. The last thing that you can do is to disable the save image icon when you hover your mouse over an image. This feature is found in older versions of Internet Explorer, so I included an image here so you can see what it looks like. It has a picture of a disk icon which you would click on and that would give you a save image prompt. So to disable this feature, you need to add another script into WebEasy, and these steps are the exact same as the no cache script you did earlier. So back into the inspector window, you just need to click the value next to head elements. And if you've already added the no cache script, you need to put your cursor at the end of the text and then press Control and Enter at the same time, and that will drop it down on a second line. So you just need to paste in the following no image toolbar script. And again, feel free to pause the video to copy this down. So once you've added the script, all you need to do is just press the OK button, and that's pretty much it. Well, that takes care of the basic methods to help protect your images. There are more elaborate options, such as disabling source viewing or even the print screen. But in my opinion, it's more trouble than it's worth. If people want to get to your images, they will. If you find your images or your content still being copied, you can send them a nice cease and desist letter, but you'll need their contact information to do that. So if their website doesn't list that, you can do a Whois search by going to whois.net, and you can look up their domain name and find their contact information. Hopefully it doesn't escalate further where you need to get a lawyer involved, but that's what some people have to do. Anyways, I hope you found this information helpful. Feel free to subscribe, and thanks for watching.